Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard.
In the last two classes, we had studied this chapter, this poem, The Patriot, written by Robert Browning. And today we are going to see what are the important questions from this part. And we will first take the first three stanzas, solve all the important questions over there, see what are the answers, and then in the next class we will move to the next set of questions. Let's see question number one. It was roses, roses all the way, with myrtle mixed in my path like mad. The house roofs seemed to heave and sway. Had I say, then there is a gap, okay? Had I said, good folk mere noise repels, but give me your sun from yonder skies, they had answered, and afterward what else? So this is the quotations. Then question number one, why is his path filled with roses? How much marks is allotted to this? 2 marks. So a year back, why was his path filled with roses a year back? A year back, the patriot had received a grand welcome. This is an important point, a grand welcome by his people. People were showering flowers that are roses and myrtles on him. So they were showering flowers and roses. What flowers? Roses and myrtles. From everywhere. Why they were doing it? To welcome him. Okay, so his path was filled with flowers. Next, we'll move to question number two. What does the word roses symbolize? In the class, we had done what it symbolizes. Roses are the symbol of what? Symbol of love, symbol of honor, symbol of respect. So why 2 marks is allotted in this question? Because you will have to mention these key words in your answer. Love, honor, respect. This is the, these are the words which identify with the roses. Roses are the symbol of these words. Okay, we'll move to question number three. Explain the lines, do you remember? And afterward what else? The people would say this, these things to the patriot. What you will have to explain this, these lines. Okay, so this line exaggerates. What is this? This is a hyperbole. So you'll also have to mention that in the answer. Why? Because 3 marks is allotted over here. So it is a, it needs to be an answer with a lot of points. So first you will have to write, this is an exaggeration of what? Of the love for the patriot. The people had a lot of love, extreme love for their patriot. That was enormous. Okay, that is an exaggeration of love. And what is this? Figure of speech over here is hyperbole. A year back, now you describe it. A year back, if the leader had asked for the sun, now you are explaining the lines. If the leader had asked for the sun, which is the most important thing for from the people, then he would readily means very easily give it to him, and then would even ask that what else do you want? Do you want anything else? They would ask this. They could do anything and everything. This is the last concluding line which you must add, that they could do anything and everything for their patriot or for their leader. Okay. Next, we'll move to question number B. What is the reference? Alack, it was I who leaped at the sun to give it my loving friends to keep. Not man could do have I left undone, and you see my harvest, what I reap this very day, now a year is run. So over here, what is the first question? The first question is, who is I in the above extract? Who is this I? Here you find the word I. Who is this one? This one is obviously the patriot. Only 1 mark is allotted over here. So you will directly write what? I refers to the patriot over here. This is the answer to the question. Next, we'll move to question number two. What is meant by leaping at the sun? Again, 3 marks is allotted over here. This is going to be a big answer. You have to write about the myth we were talking about. I told you a story, the mythical story, the mythical reference over here. You'll also have to talk about that. So you will say that it is talking about the mythical reference of Icarus and Daedalus. You can mention his father's name also. What did he do? He flew very close to the sun. Why? Because he was over ambitious. He had a lot of ambition. He felt that he could do anything and everything. Now what happened? Perhaps the patriot had taken, when you are over ambitious, okay, then wrong things happen with you. You should not be over ambitious. You can be ambitious. You can feel that, okay, I will work hard and then I will succeed. But if you are over ambitious, if you think that, okay, without doing anything, I will become the king or the president, then it is something which is wrong. So perhaps Like Icarus, this man, the patriot, had also become overambitious, and that is why people stopped liking him. Had taken a step too far, maybe he had done something which was a step too far, and that was his error or that was his mistake maybe. Maybe the people, you also can write this line, maybe the people had misjudged him and so he lost popularity. Why did the people hate him so much? Maybe because he had done something which the people could not understand, or people thought that it was wrong. Maybe he tried to do something good, okay, to an extreme level, but the people could not understand it. They misinterpreted it, and that is why started hating him. They thought that this patriot is harming them. That is why they started hating him. That is all. Next, we'll move to question number 3. This is the last question for today. Explain the figure of speech used in the line. You have to explain the figure of speech. Where? Which line? You see my harvest, what I reap. Okay, this one, harvest, is an important question. Okay, 3 marks are allotted again. Important, you have to write a lot. First, you have to describe what harvest means. The patriot's deeds have been referred to as harvest. This is a symbol, metaphor. So you have to say that this harvest means the patriot's deeds. Okay, and reaping, there is another word, what I reap. This means the consequences, that he has done his work and now it is time to see what is the result of it. So the consequences or the result is identified from this word reap. Okay, so now you will explain why the word harvest is used over here. A farmer tends to his crop so that there is a rich produce, so that he takes care of his seeds so that they grow into little plants and then they grow into crops. They take care of their plants, they use fertilizers, they water it, they sun it. Okay, so why do they do that? So that there is a lot of produce, so that a lot of crop is produced. Then similarly, the patriot had devoted all his life, isn't it? He did everything. He did whatever was possible for his people, and then it was time after a year to see what would be the result of such selflessness. He feels that he selflessly worked for his people. Okay, he was not selfish. He did whatever was selfless for his people, and now it was the time to check the result. So it was the time to see the harvest, or see what he has reaped, how much crop he has produced, or what was the result of so much care towards his people. Okay, so that is all. This is the first 3 stanzas of the poem. In the next in the next class, we'll be doing the next 3 stanzas. Okay, if you want me to discuss any particular chapter or Merchant of Venice or any part of it, then you please write in the comment section. If you have liked it, if you want your friends to see it, then please subscribe and also share it. Okay, thank you so much, children.